When you're working with web forms, one of the most important and first things you're going to need to do is get the values out of the form fields. So let's look at how we can do this with text fields to start off with. I have these quantity desired fields right here, and I'm just going to fill in a value for each of these. So the first one will be 1, second one will be 2, and the third one will be 3. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to use some JavaScript so we can get the values so we can use them later on in our calculations. So I'm going to open up the developer tools and look at the console so I can show you how we can do this. I'll open the developer tools by going up to the wing menu, and I need to just make my browser a little smaller so you can see this, but I'm going to come to the wing menu, tools, and then developer tools. And that's going to open up the developer tools down at the bottom of the browser. So this is going to give us access to these developer tools, which are really helpful when you're developing. I'm already looking at the console section, but I believe when you first open this up, you'll have the elements will be the active tab. So you're going to want to click console to go into the console section. And what we're going to do is we're going to try some different methods for accessing the form elements that are on our page here. When you're working with forms, you'll see that a lot of various code that you'll see online is document forms property. So if we just go ahead and type in the console here document.forms and hit return, it's going to go ahead and get an array of all the forms that are on a document. Now in this case, we only have the one form field. This is an array with only one thing in it, and you can tell that it's an array because you get the little brackets right here. So if I just want to get that one form, or if you have multiple forms and you want to get them, what you'll do is you'll enter the square braces and you'll pass on a field for your array. So in this case, that's going to be 0 because we only have the one form. And when I do that, then I just get the first form field. So the results are the same, but you can see that this doesn't display with the brackets as this top one does, so this is not spitting out an array of all the form elements. So instead of getting an array, we just get this one form. So now, if I want to get a specific field in there, what I need is I'm going to enter what I just placed on my console, and you can easily repeat what you've placed in your console by clicking your up arrow on your keypad, and that just copies whatever you previously typed and we'll add it, and then you can go ahead and continue typing or augment that. So that's really helpful when we're using console. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to put dot, and then I'm going to write elements, and this is the elements property, which is another array in itself. It's an array of all the elements that are in the form. So when I hit return there, you can see that it outputs an array indicated by the square brackets, and then it's going to tell me all of the form elements that this particular form contains. That's all the fields. If I want to get a specific one of these fields, then I can put in the square braces again after elements, and I can take the first one. So if we enter 0, like we did before, followed by the square brackets, and hit return, you can see that now it's going to input out my very first form field, this first element. So this is the 0th element of the elements array. We can now see this first element, and if we take its value, so again I'll use the up arrow to put that in, and then I'm just going to add the value property by using a dot and entering value, and now when I hit return, you can see that it's going to give me the value of that particular field, so it's outputting 1. If we go ahead and we change the element to the second element and we click the and we ask for the value, when we click return, it's now going to output 2. And of course, if we did that on our third element, which is this one right here, and we hit return, then it's going to output 3. Okay, so that works just fine. But if I decide I want to move these around, I'd have to go back and change all of the accompanying code. So this is not an ideal method to get this information. I'm going to clear my console by typing clear open close parentheses, and that just wipes out everything in the console, just to clear that out. And now we're going to use another method. So this time we're going to use document.getElementById. Now if we hit return right now, you can see that it's going to just pop out a function getElementById. What I need to do is, in order for me to get a single element from the document object model by its ID, well, I need to know what the ID is. So if we click on one of these elements and if I inspect the element, it'll take me to the HTML code and show me the HTML code for that element. So I can see that the ID for this particular text field box is text -q-or. So if we go back into the console and if we use our document.getElementById, and if I open the parentheses and in a set of quotes, if I go ahead and enter the name of that particular ID, like so, and now when I hit return, you can see that it's going to go ahead and output that particular input field. So I can see the actual element here in the console, and if I want to get its value, what I can do is I can enter that exact same code and just add on the value property, and you can see that it'll output the value property for me. The value property is going to work both for getting the value that it's reading or for setting the value too. So for instance, if I enter this again and if I just follow the value by an equal sign, and let's just put a number of 88, and if I hit return, if you watch this first text field, when I hit return, it's going to populate that text field box with the new value that we specified. So here you can see that you can select a particular element by using its ID, and then you can actually make changes to it via the JavaScript as well as read what is placed in there so that you can get that information out. There are alternate methods for getting this information from the page, but I think that this is the easiest one, using the document.getElementById, where you have an ID on the form element and then you address it directly in this way. There might be particular times, maybe you're using a content management system that might be a little bit more inflexible or something like that. If you don't have control over the HTML markup, you might not have IDs on every one of your input fields. So if that's the case, you're going to have to use a different method to access this code. You could get the element information by name or something like that. But for us, because we're controlling the code, we're going to use this method, and we are going to just use getElementById, and we've already assigned IDs to all of the elements in our form field. So that's going to allow us to have direct control over the markup, and we can read and write the values of those text fields using JavaScript. So this is going to allow us to ultimately code this form in the manner that we would like it to function.